Do you think ultimately religion is good for human civilization? Let me maybe phrase it differently. Is what's religion good for?
Okay. Yeah, that's a great question. Thanks for asking that. Most people don't ask that. And I think it's the question to ask. Why do we still have religion? That's the question, right? Because scientists and others, scholars, humanists even, thought that there's this thing called the secularization thesis. And it's this idea that the more we progress rationally and we have better instruments for understanding our reality, the less religious we will be. But that's been found to be untrue. We're still very religious, okay? So why? Why is it around? Well, it's adaptive in some way, in my opinion. Many people would not agree with me, but I kind of see it as an evolutionary adaptation. Now, think about religions, okay? Think about Christianity again, for one. Here comes this idea, when you have this ruthless empire called the Roman Empire, which litters its roads with crucified bodies to let you know, don't mess with us, okay? All right. Here, all of a sudden, you have this guy saying, God is love, okay? Yeah. All right. Well, that's weird, okay? So why? Why does this take off? Well, it takes off because we're becoming a colonial power. That means we're going into other countries. We're conquering them. We are, you know, how do we survive together as cultures that don't clash? Well, we have to have a belief structure that allows us to. And I think religions function that way, frankly.
So religions help us the Richard Dawkins meme idea. It allows us to explore a space of ideas. And that in itself is so it's like evolution of ideas. And religion is a powerful tool for us explore ideas.
Yeah. Because, you know, if I believe that men have souls.
Do they?
Yes, they do. Okay.
Wow. I'm still trying to figure that out.
You know?
Well, I still, in terms of souls, do believe cats don't have souls. But we'll never be able to confirm that.
Maybe if we get better instruments. You know, the soul instrument. You need to come up with that one, please.
For cats?
Yeah, not just for cats, but for all animals and people in general.
For sure.
You could put them in like a little, you know, soul machine and find out what's the status of their soul.
That's funny. I hope we'll become a scientific discipline of consciousness, and consciousness is in some sense connected to maybe what the meaning of the word soul used to be. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a fascinating open question, like what is consciousness and so on, that maybe we'll touch on in a little bit. But yeah, anyway, back to our...
Religions being adaptive. I think that Christianity probably helped us become better people to each other as we moved into a more global society. And I also, it goes along with my book, which is basically making the argument that belief in non-human intelligence or ETs or UFOs, UAPs, whatever you want to call them, is a new form of religion.
And how does that work with the scientific method? Do you think there's always this role of religion as being, in its broad definition, religion as being a complement to our sort of very rigorous empirical pursuit of understanding reality? Well, there's always going to be this coupling. Will always redefine new eras of civilization of what that religion actually looks like. So you talk about technology and so on being the modern set of religious beliefs around that. Is religion always going to kind of cover the space of things we can't quite understand with science yet, but we still want to be thinking about?
Oh, I see what you're saying. That's a great question. When you say religion, I would use the word religiosity because I think that we're moving out of the dogmatic types of religions into more of a, I hate to put it this way, but an X-Files type religion where we can say, I want to believe, or the truth is out there,
right?
But we don't know that it's out there, or we don't know yet what it is, but we know it's out there. Right. So there's this kind of built-in capacity for belief in something that we don't have evidence for yet. And that's a sort of faith. So I would say yes to that question. Absolutely. I think it's adaptive in that way. We're moving into a new, we've already moved into this culture. Most people have not caught up with it yet. I see that in the school systems, you know, and I think that I'm hoping we can catch up fast because really it's moving faster than we are.